Hello, students. Today's our lecture 5 is devoted for networking. So what is a network? Network is a group of two or more computer systems that are linked together and share information. Here is given a picture of the network. So what are the network characteristics? First, it's topology, the geometric arrangement of the computers and other hardware in a network. Common topologies include the bus, star, and the ring. Second is a protocol. The protocol defines a common set of rules and signals that computers on the network use to communicate. Third, it's an architecture. Networks can be broadly classified as using either a peer-to-peer, computer-to-computer, or client-server, computer-to-server architecture. What are the NICs? It's a network interface card. This is a card that is plugged into the motherboard of a computer. It allows for internet to be connected to access, allowing it to be part of the network. So here is given a picture of a network interface card. So what is a hub? Hub is a central connection point for computers on a star topology based. Any data it receives is sent to all ports, and then only the computer that is listening for the data actually receives and processes the transmission. Here is given a picture of a hub. So what is a switch? A switch corrects traffic jam problems by ensuring that data goes straight from its origin to its proper destination with no wandering in between. Switches remember the address of every node on the network and anticipate where data needs to go. A switch can also connect to networks operating at different speeds. So here is given a picture of a switch. Bridge. What is a bridge? The basic purpose of a bridge is to connect two networks of two parts of the same network. The networks run on any two different or same protocols. Bridges are widely used to connect laptops seamlessly to a hardwired network. They can take the form of either a standard standalone device or software on a computer. So here is the given picture of network bridge linking two local area networks in different buildings. So what is a router? For years, the primary use of routers was to connect segments of networks within large companies and internet service providers. However, newer cable DSL routers are designed as a way for home users to link the internet to their private local area network. Routers also have the ability to network any number of local area networks together. So here is given a picture of network and given a picture of local area network hub and how they are connected. Router, what is a router? It's also known as bridge and router. This is a device which functions as both a route and a bridge. And here is given a picture of a router. Modem, what is a modem? Modem is an acronym for modulated demodulator. A modem is a device that enables a computer to transmit data over telephone lines by converting analog to digital and vice versa. So here is a given picture of gateway. A gateway is used for the same purpose as a bridge in the router. However, it is a combination of hardware and software that allows it to connect two different types of networks. Gateways between email systems, for example, allow users on different email systems to exchange messages. Here is given some gateways, which are PC card module and a USB module. So file servers, what are the file servers? A file server is a combination of computer, internal hardware and software that allows network users to share computer programs and data. A file server usually has a significantly faster processor, fast network interface card, more memory, and more data storage than most PCs. It may also have a tape back. Software ServiceSoft is a portion of the network operating system that serves a computer's resources to other network users. The software accepts incoming requests from network users and gives back files and other resources. Here given a picture of server hardware. In hardware, its disk capacity is an important factor. LANs always grow, so expandability is important. The file server should be able to seat more disk drives as needed. A file server and an NOS should permit you to add storage beyond any practical limit you can foresee. Disk arrays, which are composed of multiple drives and controllers, will provide fault tolerance but won't necessarily improve performance. Here is the given picture of hardware. Another slide, it's about memory needs. Hard disk appear to work faster than it actually does. Cache is space in high-speed memory that is set aside to hold the last data read from the disk. And the last, it doesn't speed the work of the disk, but it eliminates some disk access plus servers that provide only file and the print services are likely to be more dependent on the amount of RAM, the disk performance, and the performance of the system bus than they are on the protocol itself. The last is that application servers, on the other hand, can often absorb all the CPU processing power they can get. Characteristics. And that's all. Thank you for your attention.